In this video from ITFreeTraining, I will look at a number of different ways that group policy can be filtered to particular users and computers. Using these features will allow you to target group policy to better meet the needs of your organization. If you consider a typical company structure, the company may decide to divide their users and computers into separate OUs based on the location of the office. Additional OUs could also be added. For example, users could be moved into OUs called sales and marketing. Computers could be divided into separate OUs. For example, additional OUs could be created based on the operating system that is being used. This kind of structure works well with group policy. All you need to do is tailor the group policy depending on which OU it is applied to. For example, if you wanted a group policy to only affect Windows 7 computers, you would apply the group policy to the Windows 7 OU. The problem with this approach is that it requires an administrator to sort the objects in Active Directory into the correct OU. This requires the administrator to not only have access to do this, but the administrator also requires the knowledge of which objects go where. Although this may not sound difficult, on a large network, you may have hundreds or thousands of users and computers that need to be sorted. Now imagine that later on, a number of the computers were upgraded to a newer operating system. After the upgrade, these computer accounts would need to be moved to the correct OU. The system of sorting objects into OUs is good, but in some cases, it is not ideal. In some cases, you may want group policy to be able to detect which operating system is used or apply group policy based on membership of a group. In this video, I will look at a number of different ways group policy can be targeted to specific users and computers without having to move user and computer objects around in Active Directory. Without further ado, I will change to my Windows Server 2008 R2 domain controller to look at how to configure these options. To demonstrate how to filter group policy, I will first open Group Policy Management from Administrative Tools under the Start menu. In this case, the filtering that I apply will be on the New York policy found under the New York OU. The first level of filtering you should consider doing is disabling the user or computer configuration if it is not being used. To do this, select the tab Details. Here you can see the GPO status is currently set to Enabled. This means both the computer and user configuration in this group policy will be applied. Remember that each group policy object contains a user side and computer side. If I want to, I could disable the whole group policy by selecting All Settings Disabled. But in a lot of cases, you will want to select the option Computer Configuration Settings Disabled or User Configuration Settings Disabled. When group policy settings are applied, both sides of group policy are downloaded and applied regardless of whether any settings are configured or not. If you want to speed up the processing of group policy and you know that only user or computer settings will be used, disable the configuration side that is not being used. This will reduce the time taken to apply group policy on your clients. In this case, I will choose to disable user configuration for this group policy. Once disabled, if I select the Settings tab, this will show the settings that have been configured for this group policy. Notice that user configuration is listed as disabled. In some cases, you may want to configure group policy to target particular users or computers. This can be done by sorting users and computers in OUs using Active Directory users and computers. But in some cases, you may want to use groups, or it is difficult or impractical to sort Active Directory objects into OUs. To do this, I will select the Scope tab. The Scope tab defines which users and computers this group policy is applied to. Notice that the OUs that this group policy is applied to are listed. In this case, only the New York OU is using this group policy. Notice that under Security Filtering is Authenticated Users. This determines which users and computers this group policy will be applied to. Authenticated users means any users and computers that were authenticated by the domain controller successfully. It does not matter which groups the user or computer is a member of. In this case, I will remove the authenticated users group and add the group G-Sales Staff. This is a global group that contains only sales users and their computers. This means that this group policy will now only be applied to users and computers that are members of this group. This is a good way of narrowing down which users and computers this group policy will have an effect on. In some cases, you may not be able to use groups to narrow down or target the particular users or computers that you want the group policy to work on. For example, perhaps you want to target particular computers that are running a particular operating system. To do this, you can link a WMI filter to the group policy. As you can see, there are no WMI filters to select from, so I will need to create one first. To do this, select WMI filters, right-click and select the option New. For this WMI filter, I will create a filter that will check for Windows XP with Service Pack 3. Once I press Add, I can enter in the WIM filter that will be used. In this case, I have the WIM filter in a text document which I will copy and paste. It is beyond the scope of this video to go too much into the syntax used by WMI. The syntax used is standard SQL. You can see that the query is selecting all records with information about the operating system. There are many records returned, so the next statement, where, states only those records where the caption is Microsoft Windows XP Professional. This will limit the records to Windows XP clients only. Additional conditions can also be added. For example, another check can be added that checks to see if the client has Service Pack 3 installed. There is a huge amount of data that can be retrieved using WMI. If you are looking for a particular setting, you can download WMI Explorer software, which will allow you to look through WMI data so you can find the data that you are after. If I exit out of here and select New York Policy, I can now select the WMI filtering option and select the WMI filter that I just created. You are only able to select one WMI filter per group policy, but you can make the WMI filter as complex as you want. One word of warning with WMI filters. For every user and computer that this group policy is applied to, the WMI filter will need to be executed. If you use a lot of WMI filters, or filters that are complex and take time to run, this increases the time it takes for group policy to be applied. In some cases, you may want certain users or computers not to have this group policy applied to them. For example, perhaps you have a group policy that is applied to all users, but you do not want it applied to a test group. In order to achieve this, select the Delegation tab. Delegation is a funny name for this tab, as essentially this tab is permissions of the group policy object. To view and change the permissions, I will select the Advanced button. Here you can see that the group G Sales Staff has been added to the security of the group policy object. You can also see that this group has been given the read and apply group policy permissions. In order for group policy to be applied, both of these permissions need to be applied. If only one of these permissions is ticked, the group policy will not be able to be applied. In this case, I will add the group IT Test Group. This group contains all the users and computers that are taking part in application testing. For this reason, it has been decided that this group policy will not be applied to these users and computers as it may affect the testing of that application. To achieve this, I will configure Read and Apply Group Policy to Deny. Ticking either of these will prevent the group policy from being applied. Once I press OK, I will get a message indicating that Deny Permissions override all other permissions. The deny permission should be used rarely, because if a user is in two groups and one group has deny permissions configured, they will effectively be denied access. In this case, this is what I want, but in many cases, you can achieve the same result without using deny permissions. Microsoft recommends only using deny permissions when you have to. In this video, I have looked at the ways group policy can be filtered and thus targeted towards your users. Although you can achieve some powerful results using these techniques can increase the complexity of your environment, so careful planning is essential. Thanks for watching this video from ITFreeTraining. For more free videos for this course and others, please see our YouTube channel or webpage. See you next time.